Hello, interested nursing students. My name is Sasha Edwards, and I'm the clinical compliance nurse for UTA College of Nursing and Health Innovation.
And my name is Sharde, and I'm the immunization nurse for UTA Health Center. We wanted to talk to you together about the immunizations you will need in the nursing program.
You will receive most of your immunizations before you enter the upper division program. You can find information about the required immunizations and testing at the website listed on the screen. As you progress through the upper division program, you will test annually for TB and receive a flu shot each year. It is important to remember that you must be clear for the full semester, so don't get your TB test done until you are instructed to do so in your acceptance email.
Now let's talk about each of the vaccines required. The hepatitis B series is three immunizations received over a six-month period. You get your second dose 1 month or a minimum of 28 days after the first dose, and the last dose is 5 months after the second. 4 to 6 weeks after your last dose, you will need to get a surface antibody titer to ensure you are immune. You must have two complete series or six vaccines for us to accept a non-immune titer.
So what if you had the Hep B series as a child? In this case, we recommend you get a surface antibody titer to check immunity, but make sure you are doing this early enough before starting the program in case you do not have immunity and need to repeat the series. This means that you need to start the series approximately 1 year before you plan to start the program.
You may choose to get the Twinrix vaccine, which is the Hep A and Hep B combo. This combo is a series of three doses following the same time frame as the hepatitis B vaccines. A third option for the Hep B vaccine is the Heplisav B, which was approved in February 2018. This vaccine series requires two doses at least 28 days apart.
Heplisav B is a new hepatitis B vaccine. Please be aware that this vaccine may not be widely available in your local pharmacies or doctor's office. Next up is hepatitis A vaccine. This is a series of two vaccines given a minimum of 6 months apart. No titers required for Hep A. If you have your record from childhood showing that you received the vaccines, then nothing further is needed. If you do not have acceptable documentation, you should get an antibody titer to ensure immunity. Remember, acceptable records include a signature or stamp from the provider, like the ones you see here. Documentation that does not have a signature or any administration information will not be accepted and could therefore jeopardize your spot in the upper division program.
The third requirement is the MMR vaccine. The MMR is a series of two vaccines given a minimum of 28 days apart. No titer is required for the measles, mumps, or rubella as long as you have acceptable documentation of two vaccines. If you receive a titer for the MMR, the lab report you submit must show the three diseases listed separately with testing done for each. If you receive a negative or equivocal titer for mumps or measles, you must complete the series again, meaning you will need to get two vaccines. If you receive a negative or equivocal titer for rubella, you will only need one MMR booster.
Varicella or chickenpox is the next requirement. Varicella is a series of two vaccines given a minimum of 28 days apart. No titer is required as long as you have acceptable documentation of the two vaccines. If you did not have the vaccines and or the disease as a child, you will need to get an antibody titer to show immunity. If your titer comes back equivocal or negative, you will need to receive an additional two vaccines.
If you need modified live vaccines, which are MMR or varicella, do them at the same time. If you need both vaccines and only receive one, you must wait at least 28 days until you can start the other vaccine. For example, you received an MMR vaccine and next week you realize you need a varicella vaccine. You must wait 28 days from your MMR vaccine to start the varicella vaccine.
TDAP is a vaccine that includes tetanus, diphtheria, and pertussis. This is different from a TDP, TD, TDAP, or TD, which are not acceptable as a nursing student. The TDAP vaccine is valid for 10 years and must be good for the full semester. So if it expires in the middle of the term, you will need to get an updated vaccine by the due date.
The influenza or flu vaccine is seasonal and offered between late August to March. If you're planning to start in the fall semester, you will not have documentation to submit upon acceptance, as the season will not have started yet. Spring semester starts should have the vaccine documented upon acceptance.
Now that you know what immunizations you need to have, let's talk about where you should get them. You may go to your doctor's office or clinic, a county health department, a pharmacy, or if you are a current UTA student, you may get them done at the UTA Health Center.
Some things to keep in mind if you use the UTA Health Center. One RN operates the immunization clinic, which is me. So if you call and no one answers, please leave a message and someone will return your call within one business day. Also, this is a walk-in clinic with patients seen on a first-come, first-served basis. There may be a wait, especially if you come in a group. Remember, you are representing the College of Nursing, so practice professionalism. Be respectful to our staff. We're here to help and happy to answer questions to the best of our knowledge, and sometimes we may have to refer you back to the College of Nursing for the best answer.
The UTA Health Center only has record of immunizations and tests that you completed there and cannot provide records for vaccinations not received with them. If you are coming in for a consultation, it is helpful to bring your immunization records. Please read the information that the College of Nursing gives to you to better understand what you need when you get to the immunization clinic.
The health center follows the CDC and ACIP guidelines and are not able to do things earlier than recommended or that aren't recommended just because your family doctor or pharmacist said it was okay. Titers are not medical emergencies, so cannot be ordered as stat. Due to HIPAA and FERPA, the College of Nursing does not have access to your health center records. You must submit these to the College of Nursing yourself. Get more information about the UTA Health Center at the link shown.
Clinical compliance is truly an important component of your nursing education and one you should take seriously, both for your patient's safety and your own. We truly appreciate your prompt attention to the clinical clearance deadlines. If you have questions about the required immunization or documentation, please feel free to email us at the address shown here. Oh, and be sure to save copies of your immunization records for yourself. You will need them when you are hired for your nurse residency after graduation.
We wish you tons of success in the nursing program.